Joe, and welcome to the 44th edition of Cyclone. Here's your play-by-play commentary, Cat Ion, back at it once again. And right now, we have somewhat of an address by the Party Man, Luke Evans. I mean, last I checked, the Party Man, Luke Evans, has an Intercontinental Championship rematch, but you don't know if you can discuss that yet. But right now, it's time to bring the party to Nashville. Party Man always likes to bring the fun to Shock Nation Wrestling. Always likes to bring his smile. And the Party Man, and I don't know if anybody knows this, but that was the first time that he ever competed in the main event. Was on the last edition of Cyclone. We competed in a Fatal 4-Way to determine the number one contender to Tom Watson's world title. Well, the question is, what's next for the Party Man? We're going to find out momentarily.
Hi, partiers. We're going to speak now as the man behind the Party Man character, Luke Kaner. And just want to say thank you to everyone in Shock Nation Wrestling for the opportunity that they gave me for the past couple of years. But I'm afraid this is goodbye. I just don't have the passion for wrestling anymore. And SAW deserves better wrestlers, really, on their shows. And I don't want to be taken standing in anyone else's way who deserves the opportunity. So I just want to say thank you so much to Shock Nation Wrestling. And I'm sorry that I'm going, but I've had great memories of Shock Nation Wrestling, but I just don't have the passion for it anymore. And I'm just ready to hang my boots up. But I wish SAW the best. SAW was here before I ever came, and they'll be here after, and hopefully they'll be much better in the future as well, and they'll get really good stars. So SAW, thank you so much for the opportunity.
Wow. What a shocking development here. And there's the... I believe it's 43. I don't know what he's doing out here. I guess he's supporting his friend in his final farewell.
What? Wait a minute! No! No! Barney Green just attacked Luke Evans on his way... What the hell is this all about? Barney Green is just assaulted. He just gave him his retirement speech. And he's just going to attack him anyway. I thought these two were friends. He tore his freaking suit off. Oh, come on now. Damn it. Get him out of here. That's Damian Valentine! Damian Valentine's coming in for the save! Finally! Someone has to stop this! And Damian with a drop kick! These guys have been having bad blood ever since! They first faced off at SNXT! I knew something was fishy when I saw Barney Green come out here! Oh! Damian's gonna finish this one off! Oh no! Barney Green! And Barney Green's gonna get the hell out of Dodge! He wants no part of Damian Valentine here right now! But I think he made a couple of enemies more than friends right now! We'll be right back.
Everybody's got a pass.
But I look to the future.
And yet those voices still linger.
I
but I don't care about them.
All I care about is the score.
Something was done to me.
And I'm coming to pay back.
Every single cent.
This isn't revenge.
This is vendetta.
To be remembered in this game, you have to shock the nation. And we have shocked this system for the past decade. Yours truly, the iconic DED, Mikey Truth, alongside my cousin, the Golden Boy. We are greatness personified, and we have proven we are the DNA of success in that squared circle. It doesn't matter how big, how small, lightweight, heavyweight, it doesn't matter in between. We are destined to cement our legacy, not only as the best to ever do it in singles competition, but as a tag team, No Remorse Mafia is untouchable, especially here in Shock Nation Wrestling. The SNW Tag Team Championships in our grasp, in our vision, in our sights, and we see it and we have it. Greatness personified, and we raise the prestige of every division we work in. And being the workhorses that we are, we know we are bound for a war. And War Machine, you guys need to bring that war. It's in your name. Because you will realize real quickly once again that there's no remorse for your souls when you're in the ring with yours truly, Mikey Truth, and my cousin, the Golden Boy, Shane Ashton. The fact of the matter is this: you can be toasted and saluted as tag team MVPs, top contenders for the gold, but that means nothing when you don't have the gold around your waist. And the fact of the matter is this: No Remorse Mafia is the best. We will forever be the best. And our names will go down in the hands of time as the best damn tag team in Shock Nation Wrestling history. Best believe it and better get used to it. Know this: all machines are bound to break down and fail. However, within all wars, in the sands of time, the truth always prevails. and War Machine, you will quickly learn that the truth hurts. And we have no remorse for your soul.
And here we go. Our first official matchup of the night. 6-woman tag. And right now, this will be a good time to find out who's going to become the next number one contender for Toxic Divas World Title. And right now, here comes the quote-unquote Dancing Savage. Diamond Shine is in the building. I know that's her music. And where the hell is she?
Always likes to give out a flashy entrance. Oh, there she go. Diamond Shine has had an impressive a singles record. Unfortunately, she wasn't yet to get an opportunity.
I think it's more championship. Dancing Savage, the spectacular one. I mean, she's flashy in the ring, and she has a flashy entrance. But at some point, she's gonna have to buckle down and get back in contention for the Women's World Championship. I've seen her work in other promotions, I've seen her win championships, but she has yet to get on the ball when it comes to Shock Nation Wrestling. Let's see if she can get back on the right track tonight. It seems like Toxic Diva has yet to address her previous opponent, but you didn't see it back on Warzone. They both shook hands, and I guess it was a sign of respect, but a sign of competition. I guess that's what Toxic Diva is all about. She wants competition. She wants the smoke. It seems like now, here comes the former SNW Women's World, two-time SNW Women's World Champion, and currently the longest reigning champion in this company's history. 364 days has yet to be beaten. Guess Toxic Diva so far has given Jezebel Cooper a run for her money. But I believe Jezebel Cooper is on the number one longest reigning champion in combined days as the Women's World Champion. But ever since the season started, she's been on a huge losing streak. I mean, she lost to Toxic Diva in the Triple Threat. She lost to Elizabeth Friesen in the qualifier. I mean, this is not looking good for Jezebel Cooper. And surprisingly, nobody from the road is even helping her out here. That's extremely strange. You would think that she'd at least have some type of help, but I guess she wants to do things on her own. Who knows? And here comes the former number one contender, Tiffany Taylor, looking to get herself back into another shot facing Toxic Diva. I mean, seriously, the fight that she put up back at Warzone was a career-defining moment. Unfortunately, it was not enough to capture the Women's World Championship. And a lot of people were actually going on Tiffany Taylor actually winning the Women's Championship off of Toxic Diva, but unfortunately, she couldn't quite, I mean, she had the talent. Clearly she had the talent. She only needs possibly one more shot to potentially grasp the belt. Who knows? Here comes the wild card of this 6-woman tag. Dainty Blake, who's been making a name for herself, regardless of her win-loss record. And right now, Daisy Blake, if she can be part of this winning team, she could possibly herself back into the championship hunt. All she needs is one possible move. One possible move to potentially get yourself back into championship potential. And the funny thing is, she's on the side of the current champion. So, I mean, on top of that, this could possibly, if she plays her cards right, this could possibly be on the verge of her first official victory here in Championship Wrestling. Who knows? And here comes the, this one will definitely be a nasty threat to Toxic Divas Women's World Championship. Unfortunately, she's going to have to put her front of the sign for right now to team up with the champ and her former challenger. Teresa has been at the top of the mountain before. Former Call All-Stars Women's Champion. She's held other women's championships and other promotions. She wants to add the SNW Women's World Championship on the top of that list. They call her the Master of the Dragon Sleeper. And one of the hardest kicks in all of women's wrestling right now. Her speed demon kick, if she hits it with you, it's over. Now, can Elizabeth Quasar put her pride to the side and actually team up for once? We don't know. We had an exclusive interview with the champion early this past week. She didn't have that much to say. She was basically saying, bring the competitors, I'll just keep knocking them down. A little overconfidence in the champion. But, I mean, she has the talent to back it up. And she has results as well. Now all she has to do, pick up the victory tonight, and from what I heard from General Manager Brandon Cole, that the winning team will be if Toxic Divas team picks up the victory, both Elizabeth Priza and Daisy Blake will compete against each other on the next show to crown a new number one contender. But if Taking care of the team wins, and there will be a triple threat match for the number one contendership to fight Toxic Diva at the next SNW joint exclusive event in the Survival Games. And right now, it starts off with Diamond Shine and Daisy Blake. And here we go. I love Diamond. Not a good start on the part of Daisy Blake. A huge jab right there. Great athleticism so far by Diamond Shine. Oh, a huge counter right there by Daisy Blake. She could possibly get herself back in this one. Here we go. Oh, huge knees in the corner. Daisy Blake can possibly get back in this match. Huge drop kick! Diamond Shine's back. Oh, knockout punch! Pop up knockout punch right there. I believe that gives Daisy Blake the advantage. What is she doing? Oh, never mind. I completely forgot. I didn't even know what she was doing there for a second. I thought she was setting somebody else in, but I guess not. Oh. Diamond and Shine here. And these match up a good minute. Huge boot to the face. Tags in Tiffany Taylor. We got six of the best in the world right now. It looks like, oh, a huge spear in the corner. Toxic, this is the era of Toxic Diva right now as champion. Not like she's facing scrums. She's swimming with sharks. Tag mate, back to Diamond Shine. Here we go. Double back body drop right there. Great teamwork right there. Oh, wait a minute.
Drive the truck. And she got the truck. The triangle truck locked in. Priza, what's she gonna do? She's gotta get out of it. Priza. Powerbomb. And she has to make this to hold. Priza. Back over by Diamond Shine. Oh, quick to line up from underneath. Priza. Setting up for something. What is it? Surfboard submission. No! Clip it back! That's extremely painful! Priza! Diamond tries to get out of this, but she does! Deep right now! Priza! Irish whip! Oh! Backbreaker right there! That had to hurt! Taps in the chair! Toxic Diva. Under again. Oh, rear view right there. And I guess I can see a lot of flaws right up. Oh, see? There's a lot of flaws right there. Uh-oh. A rivalry renewed. Toxic Diva. Tiffany Taylor. The fight that they have back at real time is unforgettable. And these two are definitely not the good fighter. Toxic Diva! Body shot fights it off! And right now it counters. Irish whip. Tiffany Taylor.
And it seems like now, the strike game. Kick to the mouth. And a frog splash right there. Shoulders are down. First cover of the match. Two. Only getting two.
He goes to the stretching of her arms here. Toxic Diva. What's she about to do?
Oh! Huge pan DDT right there. Cover. Shoulder it down. Two. Near fall.
Back up on her feet.
They're squaring up here. In Nashville. Uh-oh. This isn't good for the champ. What's she about to do? Tags in to Jessica Cooper? Wait a minute. She didn't see the tag until the last second. Toxic Diva did not see the tag. It looks like Jessica Cooper is going to get herself some of Toxic Diva. Right in the turnbuckle. Jasmine Cooper, very experienced. Especially the shot that you must agree. Huge move on underneath. Yoshi Karoshi right there. By Tiffany. By Jasmine Cooper. And a huge Uranaki. Rotating Uranaki right there. She can go for the pin right now if she wanted to. Wait a second. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, Elizabeth Priza trying to go for the distraction. Tiffany Taylor. Top rope pedigree. A top rope pedigree right there by the champ.
cover.
Two. Only getting two. Oh, but no. Pop right back up and sits her right back down. Tag made to Daisy Plank. Daisy Plank, Irish whip. Oh, huge move. Pop up punch. Irish whip again. And another move. More like a shoulder tackle and flipping out at the exact same time. Daisy Plank has been improving dramatically since coming to Shock Nation Wrestling. Spiral power bomb right there. Shoulders are down. Two. And only getting two. And oh, wait a minute. Everyone's in the ring. All hell's broke loose. All hell's breaking loose. Is it the hell with this? The referee's gonna have to get some type of order in persona, or else this is gonna end up being a disqualification. What a shame this would be. A great match like this ended in disqualification. And right from the top, rope onto the floor. Huge! I believe that was a reverse runner by Elizabeth Frieza. My goodness! What carnage in this ring? Wow! It's hard for me to keep track. The ref is allowing this. Referee, and it seems like now they're just jumping Elizabeth Frieza here. Tiffany Taylor just about Cooper. Oh, pops the leg. It seems like now. Oh no. Double DDT right there by Cooper and Taylor. Oh, but wait a minute. Daisy Blake's legal. Daisy Blake was still legal until now. Here comes the champion. Toxic Diva coming back in this match. And in a big way. Toxic Diva. Huge submission! Huge submission! Well, pops out before she can get her kind of shoulders down. Slams Cooper down on the mat. Top rope, shooting star! Shooting star press right there by the champion! Toxic Demon has done no! Toxic Diva with an epic shooting star press. That could have been all, but Cooper says not so fast. Clips the leg. She's going to try and steal it. She's grabbing the tights. Ooh! Extremely close. Daisy Blake came in at the last second. Powerbomb. And it seems like now, Toxic Diva from the slight distraction, the referee's down. Someone's about to go 90-90. Referee's still down. Going to sleep. Penalty kick, she got all of it. Wait a minute. Hold on. Is she gonna attack Elizabeth? Wait a second. Hey, that's your partner. What? That was your partner. What the hell just happened there? Toxic Diva in the cover. Shoulders are down. And Team Toxic Diva's victorious, but no! A Speed Demon kick seconds after the bell rang. Literally a second after the bell rang, the Speed Demon kick. Didn't even give her a chance to raise her hand. Oh, God!
Elizabeth Priza. And wait a minute, she's demanding the referee give her the belt. What is happening here? Elizabeth Priza is done playing around. She's stating her claim that she's going to be the next women's champion. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
When you're Mason Chronic, you gotta watch your back. John Blackos tried to take me out in the Elimination Chamber.
You're a fat bitch, Chronic.
And that bitch, Ben Hopkins.
It's a Hopkins thing. You wouldn't understand.
Came after me backstage. JMI tried to poison me with his vegetables and catering.
Chronic, you need to eat healthier. You're getting too thick. You need to stop eating red meat and eat broccolini.
But no matter what they do, no matter how hard they try, there is nothing and no one that can stop me.
You and me, bra and panties match right now.
I win.
No, Chronic, we all win on the AWF Network.
After a hell of a six-woman tag, we are going on to our first championship match of the night. This was for the SNW Junior Heavyweight Championship. And right now, a huge shock to the system. Christopher Konch is winning his first singles championship in his Paul career. And right now, here comes his first official challenger, former SNW Junior Heavyweight Champion, the longest Junior Heavyweight Champion, and the longest reigning champion in general in Shock Nation Wrestling history. 2 days short of 2 years. I don't know if there's going to be anybody that can possibly top it, but we got champions like Scott McShannon and Aether Animus that are giving him a run for his money. V-Pop looking to get his rematch, his singles rematch, for the SNW Junior Heavyweight Championship. Can he get it done? Right now, V has lost the steps since that ladder match. Went from a fatal four-way to a fatal five-way real quick. Unfortunately, he couldn't get the job done. But something was odd when it came to how the ending of the ladder match went down, because it looked like Joshua Campbell was trying to climb the ladder at the last second. But it seemed something was off because he felt like he was slipping off the ladder. I don't know if that was predetermined or not, but here comes the champion. And very fresh looking Christopher Konch is at that. Wow. Ever since becoming champion, he has to look the part. And right now, not gonna lie, seems like now Christopher Conscious is starting to take his role as a champion seriously. And a third eye of Carl Wrestling. It seems like now Christopher Conscious wants to make a legacy for that championship that he's holding right now. It was told
that the rep had held a championship party for Conscience in celebrations for him winning that championship. That's the one of many championships that the rep has held this year. And there was a rumor going around that the rep is told to be getting two new members into the rep. We don't know who it is yet. Heard that we're gonna find out the two members later on tonight. But right now, Christopher Conscience and V-Pop square up. First time in the singles environment for the first time in their careers. This might be Christopher Conscience's biggest test yet. First title defense, and you're already getting the longest reigning champion in this company's history. Christopher Conscience has came up big before. He's defeated a former world champion. Two, if you count Josh McCampbell. But never in a singles environment, but regardless, Conscience is coming up big this year. Hell, if he keeps this up, he might just become the rising star of the year of 2020-2021. They lock up right there. Conscience. Elbow tie up here. It's a classic wrestling style. Starting here. Oh, it's going for the knees. V-Pac. Right now. Got the arm. He's gonna snap the arm. And right now, pops the arm out of place, and that might have just given Christopher Conscience the elite gutbuster right there. And referee needs to check on that because it looked like an eye gouge. Right now, it's all V-Pac right now. Seems like V-Pac. Falcon Arrow. Right there by the champ. Right now, shoulder tackle right there. He's back in this. Sidesteps. Conscience finds a way to break free. Conscience. He's had to look up behind him. Oh, drop kick from the ropes. What the Junior Heavyweight Championship is about. High flying action. Huge submission right here. Oh, throws him up. You could have rolled him up for a three count right there if you wanted to. Right there with an arm drag. Big step. Beep up. Close it down. No! He somehow escapes. That could have been it. Right there. Huge jumping punch right there. He picks up the mention of the championship back. Oh no! You overshot it right there. I think I was going for something. Conscience rolls it up. Throws it down. Only getting one. Couldn't quite get it. Oh! Olympic slam with him! Man! V-Pac! Oh! Huge moves right there! Uh-oh, wait a second! Wow! Wow, that was impressive!
And kid, this Christopher Conscious may end up becoming a double champion if he pulls off performances like this.
Right now, V-Pac, what's he about to do?
V-Pac, Irish Whip, under, oh, bang, oh, rain! That could be all! Shoulders are down! Two! Near fall! V-Pac, wait a minute, what the hell was that? And another, it looked like a skull-crushing finale of some sort.
What's Christopher Conscious gonna do? He's gonna have to do something.
Christopher Conscious, oh no, he took too much time. Oh, or did he? Christopher Conscious, huge Hurricanrana right there. That could have set the tone up. Christopher Conscious. Oh, wait a second! Bam! Got him! What a move! Shoulders are down! Cover! Two! Only getting two! Christopher Conscious is gonna have to stay on him if he wants to keep his championship! And right now, oh! Look, he was trying to go over outside the ring and he caught him on the rebound! Oh, he wants him to bring it, but I don't know if that was a wise move. Pac, stick kicks in the corner. Conscious' championship reign is in serious jeopardy here. It can go either way. But right now it could be V-Pac in six if he plays his cards right. Tornado DDT! And this could be the prelude to what of things to come here. Uh-oh. Pac! What's V-Pac gonna do? V-Pac! Oh! He hit one of his own! Spiral moonsault right there! Shoulders are down! Oh! Christopher Conscious says, uh-uh! V-Pac, wait a second. Uh-oh, we already know what this is. V-Pac, there it is. The move that won him is very, oh, wait a second, he's not done. And, oh, God. That could be all. Oh, no, he rolls out of the ring at the last second. Pac should have put him away at that, oh, no. You zigzag. Right there by Christopher Conscious. V-Pac made one critical mistake and he didn't go for the pin. V-Pac should have went for the damn cover and he's gonna end up paying for it. Christopher Conscious, wait a second. Christopher Conscious, there it is, Third Eye Chakra. Third Eye Chakra! He wants to make sure that the job's done. He's getting him away from the ropes. Center of the ring! Shoulders are down! Two! No! V-Pac saved himself. Wow. It looks like Christopher Conscious, a throwback from the days of Brandon Wolf. He renamed the Wolf's Howl into the Third Eye Chakra. Oh! Seems like now. Uh-oh! Seems like now. Sets him down. Oh, wait. I think his knee gave out a little bit. What's he about to do? Oh, six! Sits Conscious down on the outside. Wait, Conscious, what are you about to do? Conscious, wait, hold up. Conscious, think this through, kid. Think this through! Oh, shit! Christopher Conscious went for broke, and that could be the prelude of the end of this match. conscience. What's he planning on doing? From the second rope. Whisper of conscience. Oh no, he was. I think he slipped off the rope, and this could be the. Oh, and that is exactly. And it seems like now V-Pac is feeling it. This could be the moment that he needs to win him his second Junior Heavyweight Championship. And another snap driver on his head. This could be all. Wait a second. Hold on. Wait a minute. Was that the suit? Wait a second. I believe that was Retro Carter. And that's Matt. And I know that. That's Mark Bannon. Wait a second. Got the tights. No, not like this. V-Pac survives. Wait a minute. Retro Carter and Mark Bannon making their mid-roster debut. Another third eye chakra. Could those be the two rumored to join the web? Retro Carter and Mark Bannon. Could be. They're definitely are the new members of the rep. Oh, God. The Woken Star Press. This can't happen this way. Two. Oh. Christopher Conscience retains the title. A slight distraction by both Carter and Mark Bannon was paid dividends tonight. Christopher Conscience keeps hold of the championship. Alright, right now, look at this. Look at this. Mark Bannon still on the outside with the champion. And here comes the big man, Retro Carter. Formerly known as Funky Carter from JTV. Oh man, he just knocked this boy out. Oh God! Is this what the ref is all about? My goodness! Oh God, Retro Carter with a frog splash! Well, look at this! They have assembled a new members of the rep, Mark Bannon and Retro Carter. We'll be right back after this commercial break. Don't go anywhere.
Time for those tag teams to take center stage. And right now, we have singles competition between Max Hammer and Mikey Truth. Mikey Truth has been on a roll alongside with his cousin Shane Ashton, the Golden Boy, as tag team champions. But right now, we thought that the Revolt was going to be a lethal contender. If you want to talk about lethal, look at this.
War Machine has been damn near unstoppable since arriving here in Shock Nation Wrestling. They have 2 World Tag Team Championships, 5 from 4 consecutive Tag Team MVPs, as they were just awarded their 4th consecutive Tag Team MVP a couple months ago. It seems like now that they have the moniker Tag Team MVP, they're back in contention for the tag titles. But right now, and this is a Shockamania rematch, because on Cyclone 46, we are going to see the Tag Team Championship rematch from Shockamania. Only this time, it's on No Morse Mafia's shoulders. But tonight, we have Mikey True facing off against Max Hammer. And next episode, on episode 45, we will have Shane Ashton take on Eliminator one-on-one. This is getting interesting. They want to be recognized as the greatest tag team to ever step foot in Shock Nation Wrestling. I can kind of say, they established victories tonight between both Max and Eliminator. It's hard to argue to see if No Morse Mafia deserves the tag team MVPs for next season. Because 2021 is around the corner, and right now, oh man, the big man's not going down. He said he wanted to try harder than that. And look at this. These guys, never mind. Seems like now, Mikey Truth has got himself. Oh, wait, nope. Right now, Max Hammer knocks him down. Looks like it's a rough start for Mikey Truth. Shane Ashton's giving him some words of encouragement. He said, you're going to have to try harder than that if you want to take him down. And right now, Max Hammer giving him time to breathe here. And that's the cockiness and arrogance of War Machine. The cockiness and arrogance can come back to bite you in the ass if taken lightly by No Morse Mafia. Good God, what a lariat. Almost damn near took his head off. Seems like now, War Machine, and whoa, and you gotta be kidding me. Max Hammer just did a head scissors takedown. A guy of his size, it should be deemed impossible. That was impressive. Takes him to the corner here. Max Hammer, pretty dominant in this matchup so far. It's been 98% Max Hammer in this match. I mean, you shouldn't expect anything less from Max Hammer or Eliminator. Max Hammer shows him off. Chop right there. Shoves him off with uppercut. That's how he wants him to hit him harder. And a whoa! Oh, man. Oh, he was trying to go for the same combo before, but this time, Mikey Truth with a counter and a huge splash. Oh, look at that. The spinner-rooney. Or the truth-a-rooney. Here we go. Truth building momentum. Pele kick right there to Max Hammer. He's down. Question remains. What's Mikey Truth going to do? Up there. Truth. Oh! And it clips right there by Mikey Truth. Could that be all? Two. Only getting two. The referee saw that neither his arm, but his head was underneath the bottom rope. The head does not count. Sits him down on the mat. And it seems like, oh,
drifting neck breaker right there by Max Hammer. Shoulders are down. Two. Only getting two. Truth got his shoulder up. Seems like Mikey Truth. Oh! Mikey Truth. What's he planning on doing? Mikey Truth. And oh, again! He got it again! For the second time! Oh, man! Max Hammer didn't even get a one count in. Oh, wait a second. Flips him up. Flips him up. Shoulders are down. Two. Only getting two. The athleticism of Max Hammer is hella impressive, especially that drop kick. And you're going to have to give Max Hammer some props here. He's pulling out one hell of a showing here. In singles competition. Keeps this up. I mean, who knows? He could be seeing a future singles run in his future. Oh, wait a minute. Right back. Right back. Oh, wait a minute. Eliminator from out of nowhere saw that his brother was in trouble. He saw that his brother was in trouble. But right there, that slight distraction from Eli was all that Max Hammer needed. That super kick could have done it. Unfortunately, Eliminator was not about to let that happen. Thor's Hammer. Thor's Hammer. No one ever kicks out of Thor's Hammer. And it will not be today. Max Hammer picks up the win. Thanks to the assist of his brother Eli. With a hell of a performance, Max Hammer has just pinned one half of the World Tag Team Championships. Champions, is this the omen of things to come? Are we going to see War Machine walk out with yet another World Championship?
Here's one of our co-main events of the evening. The first one is for the World Championship. It just been announced on social media that Tyler Watson will defend the SNW World Championship against the rookie Roger Blake. And it seems like Roger Blake did not come alone. He's coming out with his brother James to make sure that that they don't have any mishaps, unlike back at Warzone. Smart move on the part of Roger Blake coming out with backup. I'm pretty sure his brother James is going to stay impartial to his brother's title defense, his brother's championship opportunity. Not to mention, this is Roger Blake's first match on the main stage. A big opportunity. What would happen if Roger Blake somehow, some way, man, I think the world would turn upside down if Roger Blake somehow wins the SNW World Championship tonight. I don't think SNW will ever be the same if Roger Blake ever wins the SNW World Championship tonight. And it will definitely throw a piece of it, to the quote-unquote legacy of Tyler Watson if he loses tonight. That would be a huge red flag on the legacy of Tyler Watson. I mean, to be honest, there wasn't really that much of a legacy to begin with. Because all Tyler Watson was doing, 65% of the percent of his title defenses were tainted. He somehow walked away out of Warzone with the championship, thanks to Jarrett Cooper. Wait, hold on. I'm getting word backstage that if any members of the Revolt come out and interfere in the title match, then Watson will be hereby stripped of the championship, and it will go to Roger Blake. So it looks like Watson is on his own tonight. So he either needs to win this championship or retain his championship fairly, or he's walking away with nothing. No interference from the Revolt. Let's see how Watson fares against when it's one-on-one. It was hereby stated on social media that Tyler Watson had just became the second longest reigning world champion in Shotgun Wrestling history, bypassing Jeffrey Alford's 236-day title reign. Right now, the only person left that's on this list of the longest reigning championships is Sean Walsh at 302. Tyler Watson looking into increase his championship reign. It's his third title defense. Will he make it successful? And look, I may not like Tyler Watson all that much, but if he retains his championship clean tonight, it's hard to argue. It's hard to argue. This kid might actually make history and become not only the youngest SNW World Champion of all time, but the youngest to... Oh, wait. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Retreating. Don't tell me this is going to be a... Uh-oh. And it seems like Roger Blake's not going to waste any time. Roger... Oh, damn! I think the back of his neck hit the barricade. Roger Blake is not playing around tonight. Roger Blake, Bulldog! Watson, you picked the wrong time to gloat. Can Roger Blake pull out the impossible? Because Roger Blake would become the second rookie in SNW history to win the world championship on his debut match.
But the real question is, can Roger Blake be the second person to do so? The first person, unfortunately, is no longer in Shock Nation Wrestling.
Good riddance, too. Here we go. Roger Blake. Apparently got the champ on the ropes. Keeps this up, he might win the title. Tyler Watson is not going to let that happen. Remember, he's on his own tonight. I'm not going to discredit the work ethic of Tyler Watson. He's talented. But right now, Tyler Watson is going to have to keep this one clean as possible. I mean, I heard if you're not cheating, you're not trying, but he's taken that that statement to a whole nother level. Looks like Watson. Oh, wait a second. Tyler Watson. Oh, look at this. Used ice pick submission. It looks like Roger Blake's going to have to somehow get out of this. And look at this. Oh, sit him down. Oh, Watson reverses it. Tyler Watson. Crafty as they come. And look at this. Oh, kick right to the face. Watson. Oh, into the second rope. Okay. That was impressive. Not gonna lie, that was impressive. I'll give him that one. It looks like Watson's gonna have to. Oh, wait a minute. Oh! Sends him into the turnbuckle. Huge German suplex. And he's gonna have to get back in the ring before the count of 10. I mean, that would come out in the favor of the champion, which is Tyler Watson. But right now, Watson surprisingly not trying to let do this by ring out. We heard from Tyler Watson on social media, who said whatever happens to me in this world championship, it's on Jeffrey Albritton. But Tyler Watson, I don't know if that was oh God,
Roger Blake, come on kid. Make yourself famous. Win this world championship and shut this kid up. Please. Roger Blake picking up momentum. Roger. Oh. Trying to go for that. Oh, he was trying to go for a bulldog again. But this time Watson counters it. And Watson. Oh, no. From out of nowhere. Roger Blake. Sunset flip powerbomb. Come on! Get him back in the ring and win this championship! Come on! Get yourself a championship, kid! Do it! Roger Blake is not playing any games tonight! Send him into the apron, excuse me! Oh no! Don't tell me! Don't tell me! He's gonna powerbomb him on the apron! Oh no! His back gave out! His back gave out! And it seems like Watson's going to capitalize off that one mistake. Watson, trying to go for the rule to go around. No, countered. Slams the champion down the mat. What's Roger Blake going to do? Roger Blake, top rope. Well, how much energy does he have left? Looks like Roger Blake took too much time. And Watson capitalizes. No, wait a minute, Watson. And, oh, no. Powerbomb by Tyler Watson. Okay, that was an impressive powerbomb, kid. Now, what you gonna do now? Oh, wait a second. It looks like Tyler Watson's gonna finish this one. Tyler Driver. No! The Watson Valley Driver, excuse me.
And looks like Watson. Oh, wait a minute. I thought he was going to go for that knee. But he's going to turn. Oh, no! Quadruplex oncoming! Drop kick into the corner! He saw that drop kick coming. He saw that coming. He's used it in title defenses before. But Roger Blake has done his homework. Springboard neckbreaker. Come on, kid. Do it. Pin him. Please. Shoulders are down. Two. No. Tyler Watson says not so fast. And it seems like now Roger Blake building up momentum. Come on, Roger. Win the championship. Come on. Make yourself famous, kid. Oh, no. And it seems like Watson. A super kick. How often do you see Watson hit a super kick? Two. Three. No. He saw Roger Blake get a shoulder up literally at the last second. Just barely. I don't know if he got his shoulder up. I guess he did that on purpose so he could prolong this championship match. The arrogance of Watson. He's arrogant, but he can back it up, unfortunately. Tyler Watson. I think he's not playing around now. Scoop slam right there by Watson. I think he's done playing around. I was trying to fight out of it. No. Oh! Watson Valley Driver a second time. And I think that could be the prelude to the end. Watson, revolted go around. Oh, he can reach for the ropes. Oh no, he cuts arm over two and three. Tyler Watson remains world champion. Tyler Watson finally gets a title defense where almost nothing went wrong. Tyler Watson retains. And, whoa, what the hell? Wait a minute! That's Trey! What the hell is he doing here? He's an SNXT guy! He's a guy from SNXT! What the hell is he doing on Cyclone? Trey Jenner's assaulted the world champion! What the hell? He has a X Division Championship opportunity! What the hell is this? What? He tosses Tyler Watson to the outside! Listen to this place, the fans are eating it up! I'm confused, but I'm loving it! Thank you!
Watson! Look, man, I don't hate you. I never have hated you. This isn't about you. Well, it kind of is about you. But I've been in SNW for 4 years now, and I've never got a one-on-one match for the SNW World Title. Now, see, I've been world champion everywhere else but SNW. Well, global champion, but I've never been the major world champion. Shout out Kevin Impact. But here's the thing, though. For the last 4 years, I've dealt with all types of bullshit. I've dealt with politics that wasn't in SNW. I've dealt with inside SNW politics. And they've all kept me in this little bubble. They've always thought that I was a problem. I was a troublemaker. Partially, they're right. Partially, that's true. Double negative. Wapa. But here's the thing, though. I know I can beat you. Now, my contract runs out the same night as our main event. And Brandon Carter would love for you to retain. But sorry to disappoint you, aka spoiler alert, and Brandon, I'm walking out the SNW World Champion.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, looks like Tyler Watson finally got his competition after all. But if he loses, the SNW will be changed forever. We'll be right
back.
There's
something inside of us all. Something that wants chaos. Something that yearns for mayhem. Something that thirsts for violence. Something that begs to be freed. They are our demons. They want to break out and unleash carnage onto the world.
Wes Wade is soft, and Mike, you're soft. Wes Wade is a pussy, Mike Sutton's a pussy.
I want him in that match. I want to get my hands on him just as bad as I want to get my hands on Sean O'Connor.
I've been kicked and stomped and all the bad things from these two dumb American clowns.
Chris Knight, I am better than you in every way. And even your wife knows it.
I am the man that is going after Isaac Stone for one reason, and that is to take vengeance upon him for what he has done to my wife.
Let me remind you of something. I am not a man. I am immortal. Take your soul, and then, one final time, I will take your wife.
But first, I'm not going to come out here and call myself a legend killer because I euthanized Mason Chronic's GSF career.
That the Cobra, Chris McIntyre, has no opponent for Carnage. Mason Chronic just wasn't essential.
Onyx, you have my respect. You are a certified living GSF legend.
So the Onyx says this, the Cobra Chris McIntyre, one on one with the Onyx.
I accept your challenge for Carnage. Just remember, I'll do whatever it takes to hold on to the GSF International Championship.
You couldn't beat me in the ring one on one. Came to my father's funeral. His funeral, and disrespected me and my whole family when you laid me out with a sledgehammer and pinned me 1-2-3 on top of my father's grave.
The hands of death could not defeat me. Sisters of fate could not hold me. And you will not see the end of this day.
I'm gutted about it. Brassed off, and every god of Olympus you pray to won't be enough to stop the bruiser from ripping you limb from limb. When you disrespected my bloody family, you dug your own graves.
Tonight, there's no turning back. Surrender yourself. Let the demons take over. Wreak havoc and release the carnage.
It's time to burn it down. This one goes to the cast.
it down. Well, it's over, it's over, it's over. I won't be pushed around. Move over, move over, move over. Get back or just get out. Set this pain up in flames. It's over, it's over, it's over. It's time to burn it down. This one goes to the castaways who break their backs, saving every day.
And ladies and gentlemen, it's time for your Say It With Me, your main event of the evening. God, miss saying that. And here comes Brandon Cuevas, who recently came back and assaulted Mark Kennedy. And gave Tyler Storm the opportunity to pick up his first major victory. Pretty sure Mark Kennedy down the line will probably want to get a shot at to get even at Brandon Cuevas. But now Brandon Cuevas has a golden opportunity. Literally, a golden opportunity to capture his first championship. Tyler Storm. And I don't know if... I mean, I don't know if Roxxon intended to do this on purpose, but I mean, I highly doubt he's gonna lose. But what happens if Brandon Cuevas wins the Intercontinental Championship? Does the title shot still stand? Or, because this is the confusing part, does the title shot for Tyler Storm still stand? Because think about it. At some point, Tyler Storm and Mark Stone are supposed to step inside on a cell together. But Mark Stone doesn't back down from a challenge. So far, I believe this is his second title defense. But it doesn't look like he's 100%. Can't be 100% because he broke his damn neck. But regardless, Rockstone is a fighting champion. And I believe this is the second time since winning that championship that he's main eventing the show. I can say this right now with any shred of confidence. Rockstone, since winning that championship, has elevated the damn title. And I mean that wholeheartedly. Main event match after main event match. He could have defended the championship at Warzone. Unfortunately, he got hurt. But he came back just in the nick of time to defend his championship. But I don't know if this was a smart move. Brandon Cuevas is getting a golden opportunity to fight a not so 100% roster. Ladies and gentlemen, he's the fighting pride of the city of Chicago. The Chicago badass Rockstone looks to retain his Intercontinental Championship. But is coming back without being medically cleared worth it.
But, oh, he was medically, okay, he was medically cleared. Sorry about that. He was medically cleared, but he's not 100%. Oh, he said, bring it, bitch! It seems like Rockstone. Oh, a slap to the face! Oh, what the heck? Yeah, that gotta piss somebody off. The fact that he didn't rush says a lot. He should have rushed him the second that he did that. But I guess that's the concentration from the size difference between Cuevas and Rockstone. Oh, God! He's gonna have to watch his neck. And look at that, he grabbed his neck already. Uh-oh, looks like he's gonna try. Wait a second. Rockstone's trying to fight out of it. No! And right now, look at this. Power slam! A power slam right there, and good God, did he just... What type of flip was that? What is it with big guys and trying to do flippy shit? Oh! It looks like Rockstone answers back. And right now, a ripcord neck breaker right there by the champion. Slapped him in the face again. And it doesn't look like those things did any work. They have no effect on Brandon Cuevas. And right now, what's this? Oh God, I think he landed on his neck again. I guess that's the primary target. Make sure that he does not make it to his Hell in a Cell match. And he did it again. He did it again. How does he have that much power? Oh God! Elbow strike right there, and I think Rockstone has just broken up. And right on the chin. Rockstone, what's he planning on doing? Uh-oh. He's daring him to go to the top rope. He's daring him, but he didn't want to take any chance. Oh no, the primary target is that neck. Good God. How Rockstone get himself out of this one? Oh God, right on his head, and he's grasping his surgically repaired neck. Oh man. German suplex. Shows it down. Two. One. Oh, only getting two. Man, Brandon Cuevas is taking advantage. Rockstone made it clear that he wants Tyler Storm inside that cell. Question is, will he make it to the cell in one piece? I mean, I don't know if that was Tyler Storm's plan on getting Rockstone angry enough, but right now, oh, geez, good God! Oh, God! I don't know if this was a smart move, Rockstone. I don't think that was a smart move coming back before you were certainly medically prepared. I don't think the championship, either championship, is worth it. Question remains, can Rockstone somehow find a way to get out of this title defense in one piece? Oh, or not! And a slingshot spear! Takes the big man down! Rockstone! Shoulders are down! Two! No! Only getting two! Rockstone! Finding any ounce of fight in him! Can he somehow get it done? Oh! Right to the midsection! And I don't think that did any damage to Brandon Cuevas. Cuevas! Clothesline! Brandon Cuevas! Building momentum! Oh, God! Another roaring elbow! Shoulders are down! Game! Set! Oh! Rockstone survives! The fighting champion lives on momentarily.
Brandon Cuevas. Buckle bomb. Chop to the face. Brandon Cuevas. Uh-oh. Cuevas. Oh. Rockstone up. Rockstone down. That power bomb. Ladies and gentlemen, this could be all. We can have a new Intercontinental Champion. Two. No. What else does Brandon Cuevas have to do? What does he have to do? Cuevas from the... No way! Oh! Rockstone! Knees up! Can Rockstone capitalize? No way. Good God! Rockstone, turn this big boy inside out. Rockstone. Oh, there it is. He got it. Shoulders are down. One, two. Wait a second. Wait a second. Tyler Storm. He caught the attention of Rockstone. I think he just spat at him. That disrespectful piece of trash. Get him. I guess that spat at the face. Man. That slight distraction from Tyler Storm was all he needed. And that bicycle kick could have done the trick. Oh, God! Moonsault! The big boy has lifted up itself in the air. Could that be all? Moonsault 1-2 and oh! What else? What else can Brent equip? Oh, he somehow found the energy, spat red mist in his face, he didn't care. And a slap in the face. Caught the first, oh, super kick. Super kick to the mouth. Rockstone. Uh-oh. Another neck breaker. How much does Rockstone have left? Rockstone, top rope, Rockstone, oh, double mount stop, does he have it, no, a one count, he kicked out at one, my goodness, he kicked out at one, caught the super kick again, Rockstone! Oh! Double arm trapped! DDT! Rockstone! Does he have it? Submission is locked in! Brandon Cuevas, what's he gonna do? Brandon Cuevas! Gets out of it! Oh no! He got out of it! But no! Sends it right back down! That trail clawed choke slam, green mist. You know what time it is. Another one. He hits it a second time. Will that be it? And another flatliner. The Fighting Pride of Chicago retains the Intercontinental Championship! Rockstone puts down Brandon Cuevas and retains the Intercontinental Championship! Well done! Bad neck and all! Rockstone is gonna walk out of here with the championship! Oh no! I kind of... Wait a second. The lights are out. Wait a minute. How the hell? How the
how did I get behind him? Wait a second! Rockstone! Rockstone again! Rockstone again! And another one! Wait, hold up! Rockstone! That's another Rockstone! What the hell is happening? Rockstone can't prepare for this one! That's another Rockstone! How many Rockstones are there? How many Rockstones are there? Oh, wait a second. I think that this might be the prelude of what's about to happen to Tyler Storm. Oh, no. Remember, this is exactly what happens. Damn him. Back on Cyclone 43. And another one. Super kick to the back of the neck. I'm not going to have a voice after this. I don't know what the hell's going on, but Tyler Storm is in a world of trouble. Rockstone puts down both Tyler Storm and Brandon Cuevas. He can't prepare tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, what a show. We'll see you guys on SNXT. Good night, everyone. Thank you for watching.